Good morning. Come on. There's like 10 people at the front here. Good morning. There we go. Thank you. Coming up on the show, we take a look at how Azure Serverless offerings allow you to build and deploy elastic scale, cost-efficient apps on Azure. And we'll show you how adopting a serverless compute approach removes the need to worry about hardware resources and the operational complexity of running applications. The event-driven model for triggering compute power that allows you to just pay for what you use. And we'll walk through a serverless app for social analytics. I'm joined by Jeff Holland from the Azure Serverless team. Good to have you, Jeff.
Hey, great to be here.
Good stuff. So, yeah, give it up for Jeff.
Yes, I'll take it. Too kind. Too kind.
So, serverless computing seems to have picked up quite a lot of momentum over the past year, but what is it and why has it come about?
Yeah, so serverless is really in a response to a number of stuff, but mostly it's around removing all of the barriers that are traditionally there when building and deploying software so that you can solve for business needs very quickly. So traditional apps are designed to conform to the infrastructure that they're built on, but serverless apps offer an app-first model by abstracting away the infrastructure to relieve the developer of the operational complexity of running those applications. The infrastructure is only going to fire up when it needs to be. So it's serverless because you as a developer no longer have to worry about virtual machines, patching, scaling, all those pieces that traditionally you're worrying about and managing. And all of those things take time away from developing your solutions.
Cool.
So with serverless, all you have to do is provide the code for your solution or define that little bit of logic, publish it to the cloud, and the rest is automatically taken care of for you. So this means that you can build massive cloud-scale applications in a fraction of the time.
Now, what you just described to me sounds a lot like PaaS, but how does this differ from platform as a service?
Sure, so with platform as a service, you still need to choose your operating system and dedicate some reserved capacity, so you need to be able to forecast your demands, and even then, you're paying for that reserved capacity even if you're not fully utilizing it.
So how does this actually work in Azure?
Yeah, so in Azure, we have a series of resources allocated to you, but their usage is triggered by some event. So you give us your code, and whenever an event happens, it could be when a message comes in or an Azure alert, whatever you specify, we spin up dynamically the necessary compute resources, and it's activity-based billing. So you're only paying for when you're using those resources.
So to help us all, can you give us an example and perhaps explain the architecture behind all of it?
Yeah, so let's say that I have a website and people are uploading pictures and I need to resize those images. So whenever someone uploads a picture, I want to automatically resize that. So the upload of the picture in this case is the event, and this is where Azure Functions come in. It contains and runs that code, and it has a series of bindings that will actually attach and listen to that event. So in this case, whenever a picture gets uploaded, it will automatically trigger and resize the image.
Nice. So I'm a developer. I've got my chunk of code, and I just give it to Azure Functions, and it just executes.
That's it.
Nice. But what if I need my code to do multiple tasks? So if we stick with the photo example, we might want to resize, compress, create a thumbnail, and then perhaps upload it to some kind of store.
Yeah, so each one of those tasks that you mentioned would be an Azure function. And to orchestrate all these different tasks, that's where I could use Azure LogicApps to build a workflow. So in your example, they could resize the image, compress the image, create a thumbnail, upload it to some store. All of that would be executed whenever I upload a picture.
Nice.
And these tasks can be done to make sure that the next step, so let's say I wanted to upload to a store like OneDrive. What's great with LogicApps is most of the time I don't even have to write the code to integrate with sources like OneDrive because Azure LogicApps actually comes with a number of pre-built connectors.
So developers, they just focus on their blocks of code and they can utilize these connectors to integrate with existing systems.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I'll show here on my screen, this is the gallery of connectors provided out of the box with serverless apps. There's over 180 connectors here today, and these range from systems like on-premises SAP, Salesforce, Dynamics, Office, Google Docs, you name it. So you can push and create data into any of these sources seamlessly.
And it's growing all the time, the list as well, which
yes,
is cool.
Yes, so every time I open it, there's something new there.
Now, a lot of these connectors, they'll be, and what they connect to will be familiar to IT people, so it's important that both IT and devs are working closely together to integrate these connectors in a way that's best for the business.
Yeah, that's exactly right. In fact, a lot of our IT departments and IT departments we work with find value in LogicApps by making sure that the systems that they manage can be integrated with the solutions that their developers are building.
So it sounds powerful and all very well and good, but can we see it in action.
Yeah, so let's get straight to the demo then. So we're actually going to build a serverless app now. And for this, we're actually going to be able to build something pretty powerful in just a few minutes using serverless tech. So here I have a Power BI dashboard that is totally empty. And I want this thing to be populated with tweets in real time for all of the tweets that are happening about Microsoft Ignite. So I could be listening to any Twitter topic that I want. So let's go ahead and go through the tools that would be needed to build this solution and trigger whenever anybody here posts a tweet on Ignite, analyze that tweet, and publish it to this Power BI dashboard.
Cool. Let's do it.
All right. So I'm here back in the Azure portal. This is Azure LogicApps, this serverless workflow, because I'm going to create the steps for my serverless app. Now, I already showed you these connectors, but in this case, we want to listen to tweets coming from Twitter. So I can just choose that out-of-the-box connector. And very easily, I haven't had to look into any of the Twitter APIs. I'm already working and talking to Twitter directly. I'm going to have this check pretty frequently and listen to all tweets coming in right now on the official MS Ignite hashtag. So next, I'm going to add some steps. What's going to happen next? And the first thing I want to do is I'm going to use one of my favorite connectors, which is actually this text analytics connector, which uses machine learning as part of the cognitive services to automatically detect the sentiment of some provided text. So I'm going to add that step here and go ahead and pass in, as this loads up, the tweet text. So within just a few clicks, I'm able to add in some machine learning into my serverless workflow. There we go. So let's go ahead and pass in that tweet text. And just like that, now I'm going to have a score on the sentiment of the tweet from the Ignite tweet.
So once you've enabled this, the tweets start to flow in. And based on your search text, it's going to analyze whether it's a positive or a negative tweet.
Yeah, exactly right. And I've been able to do all this so far in a few seconds and without any servers.
Nice.
So let's keep building it out. And here, I'm going to bring in Azure Functions, because this sentiment step is going to give me a score between 0 and 1. But maybe I have some custom logic. I want to assign a color to that sentiment score, like red, yellow, or green, based on the tweet. So that's a perfect bit of custom code that I can use Azure Functions to solve. So I'm going to say I want to add an Azure function in my orchestration. And you'll notice here I have a library of all of the different functions in my subscription. I love Azure Functions, so I have a bunch of them. And here I have a function that I created ahead of time, which will categorize the tweet. So let me go ahead and pass in that score, and I'll show you what this function looks like behind the scene. So this is an Azure function. This is the only little bit of code that I need. In this case, the event it's triggering from is that LogicApps step. And I've written the code here that fires on that event. So it's really easy. And in this case, the solution is totally scaled and hosted automatically for me. I just provided this little bit of code. And you can see it's some really simple logic here. If the score is less than 0.3, I mark it as red. Less than 0.6, it's yellow. And everything else defaults to green. And that's it. So I've written that little bit of code. It's published to the cloud and will run on demand.
So what's happening behind the scenes in Azure from a resource allocation and the utilization perspective?
Yeah, so this is what's exciting is I provide this code, and Azure will automatically scale it for me. So I'm going to switch over here. This is a function that's actually been running all morning. It's a pretty heavy workload. But what you can notice here at the bottom is that it has automatically scaled a number of different servers. In fact, there's about 200 servers here that are executing on these resources. And what's great is that I didn't have to stand up these resources. I just provided this code, and it's triggered and scaled it dynamically to meet demand. And I'm only paying for those resources that I'm using.
And because it auto-scales as necessary, I don't have to worry about anything infrastructure related at all.
Yeah, exactly. A huge workload just went off my plate.
Right, and that was what we saw earlier was C#, right? Are other languages supported?
Yeah, absolutely. So if I come in here to create a new function, you'll actually notice here that there's a number of different languages supported, from C#, JavaScript, PowerShell, Python. And this means that as a developer, you can choose whatever language works best for the problem. And then you can develop, run, and debug these Azure functions all from within Visual Studio as well.
All of my favorite languages there.
Yeah. you're fluent at all of them, I assume.
Mostly, yeah. Especially PowerShell. So can you now go ahead and visualize the data that we saw a bit earlier?
Yeah, that's right. So I still need to populate this Power BI dashboard. So I'll come back over here to my serverless workflow. And let's add in that last step here, which is my Power BI connector, which will publish to a Power BI data set that's ready for us to go. Now, first and foremost here, while I configure this, I want to call out, I've already authenticated it against my own Power BI account. Now, we take security very seriously here. So what's actually happening is behind the scenes, we're using Azure Key Vault to securely encrypt and store your tokens. Wherever possible, we're using OAuth so that we can just use that refresh token. And if OAuth's not supported for one of these connectors, we'll always use the means that's most secure and encrypt that in Azure Key Vault for you.
And that's really important because we're connecting to data that's critical to running your business. So it's great to see that security is just built into the platform.
Yeah, that's right. And when you're connecting between multiple disparate data sources, we want to make that as secure as possible for those to communicate with each other.
OK, so what's next?
Yeah, so I've selected this data set, and you'll see the designers automatically detected the columns that are available in this data set, again, helping me just do this very easily. So now I'm just going to go ahead and pass in the tweet text to Power BI, who's making the tweet. We want that sentiment score to know how happy people are to be here at Ignite. That category is going to be the color from our Azure Functions, so red, yellow, or green. Let's see where they're tweeting from, and let's go ahead and see when that tweet was created. So I'm just going to go ahead and save this logic app, and we're done here. Now this is listening to tweets in real time coming in from Ignite. And we're at a big event now, Microsoft Ignite. So you'll see here in just a few seconds, this Power BI dashboard is going to light up. And this app is automatically going to scale to meet the needs of all of the tweets coming in at real time, or for any of you who are tweeting right now with hashtag MSIgnite. So while we're waiting for this to light up in a second as it goes to pick up some tweets, let me see. It says, it's still listening to tweets. Maybe not enough people are tweeting about it. But I'm going to go ahead and show you this other example of a workflow that I built out ahead of time, just to show you some of the capabilities that are possible there in your serverless apps. So you'll see this is the same start. This is still triggering on Twitter, detecting the sentiment, running a function. But in this case, I've also been able to add something like a condition. So that, let's say somebody does tweet something negative, I'm automatically posting an alert to a Microsoft team, creating a support case in Dynamics 365. So as a company, I'm able to start monitoring those tweets, making sure there aren't unhappy customers.
That's awesome. So now that the app's deployed, how do we test and ensure it's running efficiently on an ongoing basis? And I see tweets are starting to come
in. Yeah, there we go. So now they're coming in now. We've got a few here. A few people in Redmond are tweeting about it. In fact, so this one's new. I'm actually going to go ahead here and switch to a dashboard that I started earlier this morning. So this has been running for a while. Same idea here. You see a bunch of tweets have come in since earlier today. But just showing you that this scales automatically for us as these tweets are coming in. This is being monitored. And you mentioned, you know, this is running now, but how do I make sure that it's running reliably and that things are working? Mm-hmm. So this isn't like a traditional infrastructure where I can look at processor utilization or other metrics in the same way, because everything comes to life on that event, on that tweet. So as you're building those apps, you're actually running the test to simulate the event triggers and making sure that the app's going to work the way that you want it to as you're developing it. But we do provide a number of tracing and monitoring out of the box. So if I actually come here to this logic app that we built originally, you can see it did run and fired. And I can see all of the different runs that occurred and runs as they're happening. What's great here, too, is I actually get access to metrics and diagnostics, so I can have rich insights into what's happening. And all of this integrates seamlessly with solutions like Log Analytics or OMS. So I've switched here. I'm showing OMS, and I can see how all my workflows are performing. And before, I showed how App Insights also works to see exactly what's happening inside my function code. So I always know how my serverless app is performing.
That's awesome. So with Azure Serverless offerings, you're getting a fully managed service that scales on demand. You can build, deploy, and run your apps in a fraction of the time. But how do people get started?
Yeah, so we have a number of quick starts across Azure Functions and Azure Logic Apps. So check out our documentation page. I'll switch to this slide really quick so you can see it here. But what's really exciting about serverless is that you can just spend an hour or two. I mean, we just spent 5 minutes here and got something pretty exciting up and running. So you can just spend an hour or two playing with Azure Functions, playing with Logic Apps or Event Grid, and have some really cool apps published and in production in the Azure Cloud. So I'd encourage all of you here to go check it out. Reach out to us on Twitter if you have any questions. We have a number of sessions here at Ignite and recording for those sessions across serverless, Azure Functions, Azure Logic Apps, so that all of you can get a feel for it and see exactly the productivity and power that serverless computing can bring to you.
Great stuff. Thanks for joining us, Jeff. And don't forget to keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest in tech updates. See you next time.
Thanks.
We'll be right back.